So you've been spending a lot of time with video for your business. And you're like, okay, I am ready to like make this a real commitment between Facebook and my video marketing strategy. So now I need to know what the hell to do with Creator Studio. Let's do this. My name is Desiree and I'm here to help you grow your business with better social media and content marketing. So take action now. Hit that subscribe button and the bell below. Let's dive into this. I'm just gonna head over to the computer and walk you through what Creator Studio is.
Whoop. So this is Creator Studio. So here's what you need to know about Creator Studio. There's essentially three parts to every Facebook business page. You have this one, which is like the settings on your page. This is like the back end stuff where you can do like your general messaging, templates, notifications, all of that stuff. You can really run your business as you need to in here. The next level is going to be Facebook Business Manager. Facebook Business Manager is where you usually spend your time if you're doing advertising. This is a very comprehensive thing. It tends to get a little muddy and murky. That's why I don't tend to spend a lot of time in here. That's also why I don't do ads. But what we're focusing on is Creator Studio, where the name says up. This is where the creating happens and gets tracked in Facebook. So let's just like walk through what each section is and I can show you what different things are. So first things first, as you can see up here, and if you have just one page, it's fine. Or if you're like me where you're a manager and you have a lot, this is going to list all of the brand pages that you are an admin of. And if you need to dive into like one specifically, you just select it and go from there. So this is in our home. You can see things like how you can make your videos better, because that's what Creator Studio is really focused on, what your recent posts are, what your insights are, all of that stuff. You can upload your video and you can go live from here as well. Going into our content library tab, this is going to show all of the things that you have done on Facebook, okay? You can do all published as well. You have your scheduled posts. So this is where you'd go for scheduling your videos. You can no longer schedule content through, you know, just posting on your main page. You have to do it through here, especially with video content. This is where you're gonna see drafts, if you're saving something or you need something to be reviewed. So cross posting, so videos that cross post are gonna be like if you're working with a brand on something. So let me see if I can pull one up that would have this. So if you're working with a brand and you're doing things with them, you're gonna have this content show up right here because it means that you have told this brand that they can use this video for their Facebook content library. Then we have playlists. This is where we're going to have different categories for your videos and what you have going on. Okay, so these are like the different playlists that you have for your Facebook page. Playlists are really nice if like you have like continuous content or a series of something that you're doing. And then we have posts on our timeline. So obviously timeline is what the actual interface of your Facebook page is called. It's gonna show you just like what it looks like right now. And this is gonna show you what the content is, how many people are reaching it, what your content views are, all that good stuff. Now let's jump over into insights. So insights is where we're going to measure the success of your channel and what's been going on. We're going to have our minutes viewed, our 1 minute videos, our 3 second videos, engagement, followers, all that good stuff. Scroll down, you'll get even more information, more data about the content that you've been creating. Go through, really study what each one of these are. It's just the more you understand what's happening with your insights, the better you're going to be able to create content for your audience. Again, 1 minute viewers are important for your Facebook measurements, because the more minutes you watch, the more minutes people watch, the more Facebook likes your page. Who your new followers are, giving you the data demographics about their age and gender so that you know that what you're doing is on the right track. And then of course, when your followers are on Facebook, so you can poke at peak time. So 9 a.m. Mountain Standard Time is the most popular time of day for this audience. For retention, this is going to be all about video. The longer people watch your videos, the more Facebook is going to put them in front of other people. And then it also is going to help with your chances of getting monetized. Monetization happens when you have over 10,000 likes and you have over a certain number of minutes watched. The minutes watched are like how many minutes over 1 minute. Because Facebook adds an in video ad at 1 minute for videos that are over 3 minutes once you have qualified for monetization. Very similar to how with YouTube, in order to get monetization, you have to have 1,000 subscribers and 4,000 hours of watch time. Facebook has their own rules as well. And so this retention allows for you to know how long people are watching on any given day. So we can see for them, that they're still getting over 1,000 minute views or further 1 minute views, and it's really good for them. We can see like where their fall off is and stuff. Earnings, this is where you're going to see how much money you have made with this page so that you know what's been going on with your page. Again, you can monetize your page just like anything else. The reason you can't see this here is because I do not have access to that, because I do not have access to the money portion of any of the pages besides my own. So you can't see that, but you would normally see that here. So let's head over to our inbox. Our inbox are going to show us all of the messages that we have for any given page so that you can interact with them, engage, comment, all that good stuff, and be present for them through Facebook Messenger. The more present and attentive you are in Messenger to people, the more customers you can have. Okay, monetization, it's the same things that I had insights with earnings. This is going to show you like if you qualify for it, if you have the in-stream ads, all that good stuff. So there you go. You can see like what their in-stream ads are and all that good stuff. Again, going through all of these individually, you can see them if you are qualified for them. Rights manager. Again, this is something you have to qualify for, so you don't really have to worry about this unless you're doing a lot of high-end creating. And then sound collection. Sound collection is like where you can get audio files to download that are copyright free so that you can use them as background music for your videos, because you can't just use anything, especially if we're getting into monetization. And then here on pages, this is where you're going to see like all of the pages that you have available for you, and you can click on them and it'll take you to that actual page. So that is how Creator Studio works. If you have any questions or want to know more about it, of course, just let me know down in the comment section.
Using Creator Studio for your business is going to be super helpful for your video strategy, but maybe you need some help with your content marketing strategy when it comes to Facebook. Watch the video you see on the screen now so that you are able to crush it with Facebook in 2020. And until next time, I'll see you soon.